Allie?
Yeah. Chris?
I think this decision will be seen by progressives and probably Democrats across the board, and certainly all labor people, as yet another partisan decision. If you look at people that say the Supreme Court's not political, why was it 5-4, the five Republican-appointed judges who voted to make George W. Bush president of the United States? Why was it the 5-4 Republican majority that gave us Citizens United, which clearly helps the party with more money, that gave us the pro-NRA position of Howard, the Howard case, that took us to basic what many people on the left and center-left see as anti-immigrant legislation, supporting what the president did in terms of his EO, his executive order, on what he called, effectively was an anti-Muslim ban. And all these decisions strike most people as partisan. They're not even considered ideological, and now coming against public service employee unions. And by the way, the heart of the labor movement right now is often, if you look at who's really voting and paying dues, is public service people, teachers. They're larger as a percentage of the labor movement than construction. They're going to see this. I think everybody on the left and center left is going to say, yeah, the Supreme Court's partisan against us. This is the big one for us. We've got to stop this.
So, Chris, to your own argument earlier, though, that if you're not looking for an Anthony Kennedy, you're not going to get an Anthony Kennedy. You'd take an Anthony Kennedy today. You'd take a Trump appointee.
I don't think anybody's going to believe. Nobody's going to believe that this president who said women should be punished for having an abortion. Nobody's going to believe. By the way, we never know. We've had, Justice Frankfurter and people like that in Souter have always surprised us. You have people going from left to right, right to left. FDR thought he had somebody in Frankfurter. He went to the right. Republicans thought they had Souter in the pocket. He goes to the left. I mean, the fact is, you can't predict. So you look at the party's track record, and you look, they haven't picked many Justice Kennedys. They've largely picked non-Justice Kennedys, people who are hard right on all social issues. So I would say, I think this is going to be the fight of the century. I think the Democrats have to say, no way, non passario, no one passes this line. I think it's going to be almost like Spanish Civil War stuff. You watch.